Welcome to this third video lecture on influence line diagrams. Now before that, in last two video lectures we have seen the influence line diagrams, its applications, and the standard influence line diagrams for a simply supported beam, for reaction at A and reaction at B, then shear force at A, shear force at a section, and bending moment at a section. Now let us study in this video lecture some examples on influence line diagram and how we can apply the influence line diagram to find out the reactions for any type of given example. Now if you see this example, here in this case, though the influence line diagrams are applicable for a live load, initially we can find out the reactions for some static loads when a beam is subjected. Now if you see this example, example is a simply supported beam is loaded and supported as shown in figure. We have to determine the reaction at A and reaction at B, then shear and movement at a point C using influence line diagram. So now let us see how to find out the reaction at A and reaction at B, also shear force and bending movement at a point C using influence line diagram. Now all these three parameters, in general we can find out the conditions of using conditions of equilibrium and by our regular procedure, but in this case, here we have to study the application of this influence line diagram and how to find out the reaction. Now starting from support reaction for this given simply supported beam. Now if you see the simply supported beam, it is subjected to three different points, 80 kN, 100 kN and 50 kN. Now by regular method, by taking moment about point A and by taking f of y is equal to 0, you can easily find out reaction at A and reaction at B. But in this example, we have to study how to find RA and RB using influence line diagram. Now for that, we need first influence line diagram for support reaction at A and support reaction at B. Now let us first focus on influence line diagram for RA. Now already in last two video lectures we have studied how to draw this influence line diagram for RA. Now if we see this diagram, when unit load moves from A to B over the simply supported beam AB, we know that reaction at A varies from 1 to 0. So we get such influence line diagram for RA. Now if you see this diagram, in this diagram here we have this value of RA at a point A is a maximum one. Means when your unit load is at point A, here we get value of RA is 1. Now in this case, to find out the support reaction at A, first of all we need to project all these points where we have a point loads. For example, we have this 80 kN load, so we need to project this point in this influence line diagram. Similarly, we have the second point load, so we need to project this point here in this influence line diagram. And then for third point E, again we need to project this point in this influence line diagram. Now to the respective projected points in this influence line diagram, we need to find out the height of this diagram, or you can say these are the ordinates of this diagram. Now how to find out these ordinates? Now here in this case you can see this is 0.7, this is 0.4 and 0.2. Now by concept of similarity of triangle, you can easily find this 0.7, 0.4 and 0.2. These are the ordinates at point C, at point D and at point E. Now these ordinates we need to find out reaction at A. Now see, what is reaction at A? Now how to find this reaction at A? To find this reaction at A, we know we should have this point load and the respective ordinate. Now what we do in this case, we have to just multiply this point load by the respective ordinate. So 80 multiplied by 0.7, next 100 multiplied by 0.4 and 50 multiplied by 0.2. Take the sum of all this, then you get the reaction at a point A. So that is equal to 106 kN. So you can see here, 80 into 0.7 plus 100 into 0.4 plus 50 into 0.2, you will get reaction at A. So it is a very simple thing. To find out these parameters, we need to multiply a point load by the respective ordinate in this given influence line diagram. Now similarly for RB, to find out RB, we need influence line diagram for RB. Now we have studied that this is an influence line diagram for RB. When unit load moves from A to B, influence line diagram for RB varies from 0 to 1. So here you can see it is 0 to 1. Now in this case again, we need to first project this points where we have a point load. So we have this 80 kN, 100 kN and 50 kN. So we need to first project those points. Now at these projected points, again we need to find out the ordinates of this given diagram. So we have calculated this ordinate at a point E is 0.8, at point D it is 0.6, and at point C it is 0.3. Again, now to find out reaction at B, simply we need to take force or a point load multiplied by the respective ordinate, force multiplied by the respective ordinate. So here in this case it is 80 multiplied by 0.3, 100 multiplied by 0.6, and 50 multiplied by 0.8 will get reaction at B. So in this equation you can see reaction at B is calculated by taking product of the force and the respective ordinate in the influence line diagram. So here we have calculated reaction at B is 124 kilonewton. So now we have studied that how to find out reaction at A and reaction at B using the influence line diagram. You can verify these answers of RA and RB by our regular procedure. Now let us move to the shear force at a point C. Now here, if you see the point C, now it is at a distance 3 meter from A, and it is at a distance 3 + 2 + 2, means 7 meter from point B. Now if you see the standard influence line diagram for a shear force at a point C, we know that when unit load moves from A to B point, shear force at C varies from first 0 to minus A by L, and then from plus B by L to 0. So in this case, the ordinates of the influence line diagram at a point C, these are minus A by L and plus B by L. Now to first to know what is A and what is B in this case. Now if you see this A, now in this case A is what? It is a distance of point C from point A. So here in this case A will be equal to 3, and B will be equal to, if you see this B now, 3 + 2 + 2, that is equal to 7. So in this case A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 7 in this case. So if you put A and B in this diagram, you will get the influence line diagram for shear force at a point C. So you can see this shear force influence line diagram for shear force at a C. When you will put A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 7, you get these respective ordinates as +0.7 and -0.3. Now in the same way like we have done in the last step, here we need to first again project all these points. So 80 kN, it is already projected in this diagram. We need to project 100 kN point over here and 50 kN point over here. Now when you are projecting these points, you need to find out the respective ordinates. So here we have calculated these ordinates are 0.4 and 0.2. again, by similarity of triangle, you can easily find out these respective ordinates. Now here we have to find out shear force at a point C. Now by the regular procedure, we know that how to find out the shear force at a point C. As we have this simply supported beam, if you see, this is simply supported beam. Now when we are interested to find out shear force at a point C, you need to consider either a section just right of C. Now when you are taking a section just right of C, you will consider the forces on right hand side and you will take the algebraic sum of all these forces. So you will get the shear force just right of C. In the same way, you will get a shear force when you are considering a point just left of C. So generally we know that when we have a point loads, we get two values of the shear forces. One value you will get just right of the point C, and second is just left of the point C. Now in case of using influence line diagram, how to find out the shear force at a point C? Now again the procedure is same. We need to consider force multiplied by the respective ordinate, force multiplied by the respective ordinate. Now here in this case we have these three point loads, 80 kN, 100 kN and 50 kN. We need to multiply these three forces by their respective ordinates. Now in this case, if you see this 80 kN load, here we have two ordinates. One is 0.7 and second one is -0.3. Now if I consider this 0.7 or +0.7 in this equation, so that is 80 into 0.7 plus 100 into 0.4 plus 50 into 0.2. 80 into 0.7, 100 into 0.4 and 50 into 0.2. So you will get here a shear force that is 106 kN. You can say that this is a shear force just right of the point C. Means what? This 0.7 value, this is the ordinate of the influence line diagram for shear force at C, which is just right of the point C. This is just right of the point C. Now to consider or to find the shear force just left of the point C, instead of this point 7, we need to consider the ordinate under a point load of 80 kN as minus 0.3. So when you will consider this 80 into minus 0.3 plus 100 into 0.4 plus 50 into 0.2, you will get the second value of the shear force at a point C, that is 26 kN. You can say that this is the shear force just left of the point C. So in this way, we can easily find out the value of the shear force at a point C using the concept of influence line diagram. Now let us move to the next part, that is bending moment at a point C. Now again, here in this case, same point we have point C. So here we'll have A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 7 meter in this case. Now you can see this is the standard diagram for influence line diagram for a point C. So here maximum ordinate of this diagram is AB by L, where A will be equal to 3 and B will be equal to 3 plus 2 plus 2, that is 7. So you'll get this influence line diagram for bending moment at a point C. So here you can see this is the influence line diagram for bending moment at a point C, where we have this maximum ordinate as 2.1. When unit load moves from A to B here, when unit load reaches to point C, you will get bending moment at C as a maximum. And here you can see this is the maximum value as 2.1. Now again, the procedure is same. We need to project all these 3 points. So we have projected all these 3 points. Now we need to find out the respective ordinates under these 3 point loads. So initially already we know this ordinate as 2.1 under 80 kN, under 100 kN it is 1.2, under 50 kN it is 0.6. So by similarity of triangle, again we need to find out these ordinates. Now to find out bending moment at C, again the procedure is same: 80 into 2.1, 100 into 1.2, 50 into 0.6. So you can easily find out bending moment at point C is equal to 318 kN/m. So by the regular procedure also, you can verify those answers for a bending moment at a point C. Now let us move to the next example, where we can study when a beam is subjected to uniformly distributed load. Here we have a beam of 4 meter, which is simply supported, and it is loaded with UDL of 30 kN per meter. And we need to find out what is the reaction at A and what is the reaction at B. At the same time, we have to find out shear force and bending moment at a point C, which is at a 2 meter from point A. Again, by the regular procedure, by conditions of equilibrium, you can easily find out reaction at A and reaction at B in this case. Also, you can find out shear forces and bending moment at respective points. But by influence line diagram, how to find it? This part we have to study now. Now, again, we have considered this simply supported beam subjected to uniformly distributed load. By regular method, you can easily find this RA and RB. Now by symmetry, you can easily predict here RA must be 30 kN and RB must be equal to 30 kN. Now again, we need to consider influence line diagram for RA first to calculate reaction at A, and then we'll consider influence line diagram for RB. Now if you see this influence line diagram for RA, again it is a standard diagram. It varies from 1 to 0. This part we already discussed. Now in this case, in the last case, when we have a point load, we had multiplied point load by the respective ordinate. But in this case of UDL, where it is distributed over a length, in this case, we need to consider area under this UDL. Area under this UDL. So here we have UDL over a 2 meter distance. So we need to consider area of this influence line diagram under this UDL. So we can show this part, colored portion. It is the area under UDL, where we have these ordinates at the 0.75 and 0.25. again, by similarity of triangle, you can find those ordinates in a simple way. Now to get this reaction at a point A, here in this case we need to consider intensity of the UDL multiplied by the area. In the last case, we had taken a multiplication of a force and a respective ordinate, but here in this case we need to consider uniformly distributed load intensity multiplied by the respective area. So here to find RA, we have considered load intensity into area of influence line diagram under UDL. So here we have this trapezoid whose sides are 0.75 and 0.25. So you can consider its area. This is the area of this trapezoid multiplied by the load intensity you will get the reaction at a point A, that is equal to 30 kN. Similarly, for RB, we have to draw the influence line diagram for RB. Here, influence line diagram RB varies from 0 to 1. Again, the procedure is same. We need to consider UDL intensity multiplied by the area under this UDL. So, same procedure we have. Load intensity multiplied by area of ILD under UDL. Here again we have a trapezoid. Same trapezoid we have, but it is in the opposite direction. And again you are getting RB is equal to 30 kN. So we can easily find out these reactions using the concept of influence line diagram. Now let us move to the shear force at a point C here. Now when we are finding shear force at a point C here, A is equal to, in this case, A is equal to 2 meter and B is equal to again 2 meter. So here in this case A is 2 and B is also 2. So we know the standard diagram for influence line diagram for shear force at a C. So we have plotted by considering here as a minus A by L and B by L. So this diagram varies from first 0 to minus A by L and then from plus B by L to 0 once again. So now, to find out the shear force at a point C here, in this case, again we need to consider area under this UDL and we need to multiply the load intensity. So shear force at a C we are getting as load intensity into area under UDL. Now in this case, you can see this diagram here. Some part of the area of this influence line diagram, it is on negative side. This is on negative side, so we need to consider minus sign over there. So now again we'll take load intensity multiplied by the area. So 30 is the load intensity multiplied by area under this as first area of this positive trapezoid. So 0.5 plus 0.25 divided by 2 into 1. And similarly, at the same time we need to consider this area which is on negative side. So we have considered here minus sign. So minus 30 into 0.25 plus 0.5 divided by 2 into 1. So here you are getting a value at 0. Now you can verify your answer by taking shear force at a point C, either considering right hand side or left hand side. You will get the same answer, that is shear force at a point C is 0. Now let us move to the last part, that is bending moment at a point C. Here again we can consider A is equal to 2 in this case and B is equal to 2 in this case. So we get influence line diagram for bending moment at a point C. Here we have a maximum ordinate for this diagram as AB by L, which is equal to 1 in this case. So now again we need to consider the uniformly distributed load and area under this load. We have considered this area under this UDL. So bending moment at a point C will be equal to, in this case, take load intensity multiplied by the area under this UDL. So here we have divided this into two trapezoids. So 0.5 plus 1, these are the sides of a trapezoid, divided by 2 into 1, and same trapezoid we will get on the other side also. And hence you will get the final answer for bending moment at a point C is 45 kN. So in this way you can find out the reactions at A and B, then shear force at any particular point having some distance from either A or B, considering A and B there, and we need to draw the standard influence line diagrams for reactions, then for shear forces at a section, bending moment at a section, and just multiplying when we have a point load, multiply point load into ordinate, and when we have UDL, just multiply load intensity into area under UDL, and then you can easily find out these respective parameters. Thank you.